Thank you, Piyush. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I can observe that you are just waiting for the conclusion of this session. I know this session is heavy, but let's talk about a few slides, and I can give you an idea about what we are doing at Ministry of Railways with respect to railway projects, as well as what sort of loading we are doing, what commodities we are handling through rail transportation. So I have kept the title of my presentation as Coal Transportation and Indian Railways. Before I start, I want to give you some idea about my organization, which carries near about 23 million passengers in a day. In a nutshell, I can say that we move whole of Australia in one day, Australian population. So 23 million passengers we are moving in a day. And presently we are running near about 22,000 trains on daily basis. Out of these, 13,000 are passenger carrying trains and 9,000 trains are freight trains. And if we talk about the tonnage handled per day, we are carrying about 3 million tons of freight on daily basis. And this much hard work is being done by 1.3 million railway employees. We are having predominantly a broad gauge on Indian railway network with total track length of 1,17,000 kilometer, and route kilometer is 66,000 kilometer. Let me explain difference between track kilometer and route kilometer. Route can consist of multiple lines. If you have a double line between Ludhiana and Ambala, it's near about 100 kilometer, then the route will be 100 kilometer, but the track will be 200 kilometer. So don't confuse with the four lines, it will be 400 per line that way. So we are having near about 35% of total network on electric traction with 7,000 stations and near about 10,000 locos. We are having 2,54,000 wagons and 62,000 passenger coaches. So these are the mainly operating asset of my organization. Now if we talk about the what sort of freight we are handling, whatever freight we are handling, 47% is in terms of coal, then 12% is iron, and about 10% cement, 4% food grains, 4% it's fertilizer, 4% is PUL means petroleum, and then 4.7 is near about 5% is containers. And again, we have divided the iron into different categories like steel, iron, and rolling based steel products. So the percentage has been shown there. And if this loading is converted into terms of rupees, means how much we are earning, near about 45% we are earning from coal. Similarly, cement is giving me 8% and food grains 7%, fertilizers about 6%, petroleum 5%, container also 5% of my earning is through container. And if you club this iron, then it's 8, 7, 15 and 2, 17% from iron or iron products. Now we know that the power generation in my country is increasing at a fast pace, though for the last few years it's ranging between 5.6 to 5.4%. For the current year, till December, it was an increase of 4%. The graph of power generation is more or less parallel to what the coal is contributing in this power generation. Near about 70% of power generation is also through coal-based power plants. If we talk particularly about Indian Railways, then we can clearly see that for 2016-17, out of coal availability of 841 million ton, we carried near about 533 million ton. If you divide this 533 by 841, you will get a coefficient. We talk about coefficient, it's 63.4%. Means whatever coal is being produced, 63% of that coal is produced or imported or whatever is available for transportation, 63.4% is carried by railways.
And if you see for last few years, the rail coefficient was 70% in 2011-12 and 2012-13. But for last few years, we are maintaining the rail coefficient. Though the production is increasing, at the same pace, we are maintaining the rail coefficient also. So railway is responding to that production change, but there is a lot of potential. What we are doing to garner, cater to that potential, I shall be explaining you in next few slides. But if we see the overall loading of Indian railways, it's also again showing a increasing trend. But for last 3 years, you can see the rate of increase has not been that much steep, which was there in 7 or 8 years before. And with respect to coal, the blue curve is explaining you the how much we have loaded, we have transported the coal in last few years. Again, this loading is also following the overall curve. One of the main takeaway from this curve is that we are dependent upon loading of coal. 50% of our loading is from coal only. If we have talking about the total available coal, then this slide is showing you about the sources of coal. 60% of coal is from Coal India Limited. Then imported is 17%, and others, which includes private coal blocks also, it's about 16%. Now, how we are dealing with this issue? What steps we are taking? Naturally, the demand of passenger traffic is increasing day by day. We have limited resources, but we have to run the passenger trains also. So to run those passenger trains, but the capacity available on a particular section is also limited. If I take example of Ludhiana-Ambala, suppose in a particular day I can run maximum 70 trains, depending upon the available technology. Out of these 70 trains, now we have to decide how many we can run on for the passenger traffic, how many we can run for the freight traffic. So that way, if the total available capacity is 70, we can run 80 also, but then we shall say that the section is saturated. If the section is saturated, then we shall say that if standard time between Ludhiana and Ambala was 2 hours, but if the section is saturated, then naturally the train will be taking near about 3 hours or three and a half hours. So I hope you are at the same frequency. So in that term, what we have to do? We have to increase the capacity of that section. We have planned for investment of 8,56,000 crore in next 5 years, if I take the reference as 2015-16. Out of this 8.56 lakh crore, we will be investing 2 lakh crore in network decongestion. Network decongestion means increasing the capacity of section. You can increase the capacity of section by laying new lines or by going for electrification. New lines means if 2 lines are available, then you can lay the 3rd line. If 3 lines are available, then you can go for the 4th line. Then 1 lakh crore we are going to spend on station development and logistic paths. 1 lakh crore we are investing for the rolling stock. Rolling stock means the wagons which are used for carrying the traffic. And 0.65 lakh crore for the high speed also. If we talk in terms of the plan size has also increased from 65,000 crore in 2014-15 to 1.31 lakh crore in 2017-18. And the actual plan expenditure has also increased from 58,000 crore to 1,11,000 crore. So if we talk in terms of the infrastructure, the doubling is the execution of double lines. For the last few years, the doubling was every year 700 kilometer or 900 kilometer, which has for the 2017-18 we have targeted 1600 kilometers of doubling. Similarly, new lines also 800 kilometers, gauge conversion 1100 kilometers. So total we have targeted about 3500 kilometers of new line doubling as well as gauge conversion. In same way, we have targeted electrification of 4000 kilometers. you see, for the previous years, the electrification was 1375 for 2014-15 and 1700 kilometer for 2015-16. This means that we are investing a lot in infrastructure improvement. Let me give you some idea about coal evacuation projects. What are the important coal evacuation projects on Indian Railways? This is one is the Tori Shivpur. It's a 44 kilometer section, and the land has been acquired more than 95%. This project is being executed at the cost of 1500 crore, and this is a deposit work, means the customer is giving the money to railway as on a deposit basis, and then railway will execute the project. The target has been subdivided into three. In 2018, we are going to complete this section. It has been divided into three parts. Tori Balumath will be ready by 28th February this month. Balumath Bukru will be next month, and Bukru Shivpur is in June. The second part of the same project is Shivpur Kathotia, which is being executed as a SPV, special purpose vehicle. This is also will be available for output loading of about 20 million ton, and the cost is 1600 crore. I want to tell you about this, that these projects are being monitored at different ministry level. In fact, these projects have been included in the Pragati portal also, and different ministries are on regular in touch on regular basis for execution of these projects. Next is Jharsuguda Barpali Sardega. This will be again 35 million ton coal production in the first phase, 60 million ton in the second phase. This project has been also commissioned in 2017 December, and loading will start in March itself. This was also one of the most important critical coal evacuation projects. Next is Bhupdev Kharsia Dharamjaygarh in Chhattisgarh. Again, this project is being executed on SPV model, and 85 million ton of coal production is targeted, and land has been acquired for the phase one, and target dates I have given near about in 2020-2021, but discussions are going on to complete these projects before these target dates. Similarly, there is a second part of this project, that is East-West Rail Corridor. First was the East Corridor. This is the East-West Rail Corridor. Again, the land for out of 841 hectares, 245 hectares have been acquired, and this is being executed by SPV, which is the stakeholders are Government of Chhattisgarh, SECL, and IRCON. IRCON is a railway PSU. Now, to cater to this demand, what we are doing is, naturally, we have to plan for wagons also. If the track is available, then how you will transport this traffic? For the wagon induction also, you can easily make out that box and H wagons, in which, in these wagons, the coal is carried. Near about 7,700 wagons were required in 2015-16, near about 10,000 wagons in 16-17, and for the current year, it is near about 5,000 wagons. Already we have got 3,000, and outstanding orders are about 2,200. Next is same as for box ends, for bob ends. These are the different type of wagons which are used for coal transportation. These slides give you some idea about the different projects. I will not be talking about this, but you can easily make out that these projects are distributed in mainly in Odisha and then Chhattisgarh. And we have included those coal projects also, which can cater to transportation of coal from originating areas to market area also of northern side. So we have included those projects also under coal projects. Just like Rajpura Bathinda, it will cater to the coal plant in this area. Then Rewari Manheru, again it is very important for coal transportation in around Mathura and in this Haryana area. Then these are a few projects which I have included. Then Bhopal Bina third line, this line is very important for overall passenger movement as well as coal movement. Then you can see the last row, total doubling. We have sanctioned these projects at the cost of 34,000 crore. So for the doubling, and at the end of this line you can see total new lines near about 12,000 crore for total new lines. Then in this slide, Second last line, you can see total gauge conversion. These are the projects which can be very important for coal transportation, near about 3500 crore. And if we total all these projects, means new line, gauge conversion, doubling, then we near about 50,000 crores we are going to spend on projects which will cater to coal transportation. That's all. Thank you.